Hi there. I'm Matt with K15T, and let's look at how you can use Confluence databases for some lightweight CRM work or for managing contacts. So at K15T, we maintain databases of all sorts of important contacts that we work with, like Atlassians that we know, or business partners, or customers of interest. Confluence databases are a really great tool for these sorts of collections of contacts, but don't get me wrong, we're not talking about replacing an entire CRM system like Salesforce. Think hundreds of contacts, maybe, rather than hundreds of thousands of contacts. That's a good way to think about whether you should use Confluence databases or some other tool. In each database here, we're using specific field types to help team members find the information they need and also control the kinds of information we're storing about each contact. So for example, we have a tag field here so that people can easily designate what kind of communication preferences this contact has. Or we're using a link field type here so that we can quickly drop in someone's LinkedIn profile so that someone can quickly navigate to that. We're also using entry fields, which are a very powerful tool for connecting multiple databases so that your important information is in sync. In this example, I've connected to the sales database so that anyone looking at a particular contact can see if they're actively involved in a sales record and even check to see the status of that sale. This is a powerful way to have information in multiple databases, but view that powerful information together in a way that helps me get my work done. We've also created different views here. These have filters to limit the number of displayed entries in the database. We've also hidden some fields to ensure that only the really important ones are displayed and the others are just hidden. They're not gone, just hidden. And there's even a different layout to display the information in the best way possible, in this case, using the card layout. Now that I've created this view, I can copy the smart link and put it anywhere in Confluence, like for example, this update blog. This will display the same information outside of the database, and it's kept in sync with all the information within my contacts database. Really quick, if you haven't yet, subscribe to K15T's YouTube channel, where we're constantly putting out new videos about Confluence news, best practices, and use cases you can use to improve your Confluence skills and get the most out of it so you can focus on what you do best. So subscribe to our channel and let's get back to it. And one other important thing to know is there are restrictions. So you can decide if everyone can view and edit the database, or everyone can view and only some can edit, or only certain people can view and edit the database so that people aren't where they ought not be. Now, one of the values of managing your contacts right in Confluence is that you can work with other things like pages. Each entry in the database has a page link field, which links to a specific page where team members can create notes about their collaboration with this person, like for example, where they are in a conversation with them. They can also update the page status on that page, and that is kept in sync with the database as well. So whether you're looking at the page to see the status of that customer, or you're looking at the database, everyone is going to see that same status because it's kept in sync across Confluence. Now, this is just lightweight CRM in Confluence databases. There is so much more you can do with Confluence. So jump into another video in this series as we continue to explore how to use Confluence to share what you do best.